a 3-1 loss to the University of Minnesota Duluth in the Midwest Regional in Allentown, Pennsylvania. The Quinnipiac men's ice hockey season ends tonight. Hello and welcome inside the Rebound, presented by Q30 Sports. Alongside Kyle Lavasser, I'm MJ Baird. Kyle, let's break down this game a little bit. I'm going to get to your analysis in just a second, but first, let's hear from Quinnipiac's head coach, Rand Pecknold.
They don't have that, you know, an Adam Fox or a Kale McCarr, but they have just a lot of really good players and a lot of guys, you know, maybe 6 or 7 are going to play in the NHL. And I mean, they manhandle us tonight, you know, and our forwards are, you know, it's a young group. I don't even know how many freshmen we had. It was a lot, and we just didn't handle it well.
There's the analysis from head coach Rand Pecknold. But Kyle, I want to hear your analysis as well. What were your thoughts on tonight's game?
MJ, let's not sugarcoat it. They faced a fantastic team. Minnesota Duluth is the reigning national champions for a reason. Rand Pecknold said they have 6 future NHL players. That's something Quinnipiac doesn't normally see. Quinnipiac only had 10 shots in the first 2 periods combined, and then they finally generated some offense as Craig Martin scored to cut the lead to just 2-1. And then after pulling Andrew Shortridge, it looked like there was some hope that Quinnipiac would advance to the Frozen Four, but alas, their hope was cut short as the empty net goal was scored by Minnesota Duluth, and there wasn't much they could do about it. Minnesota Duluth is just a fantastic team. They can roll 4 very good lines at any given time. They're a very deep team, and Quinnipiac just wasn't playing their A game today.
Yeah, it didn't seem throughout much of this game as if Quinnipiac was producing enough offense. They had to play a lot of defense, and for the most part, they did it fairly well. But in turn, they couldn't play offense because they're in their defensive zone much of the game. All right. An interesting point to note here. Quinnipiac comes to the NCAA tournament here in this 18-19 season. They even win a game. But last year, that wasn't even a thought. A complete 180 from last season to this, and a lot of it, Kyle, due to that senior class. We'll get to those seniors in just a second, but what else do you attribute this season 180 to?
MJ, this is a team that a year ago in the playoffs lost 9-1 in the ECAC quarterfinal round. Now, this year, they were just a couple minutes away from possibly making the Frozen Four. That's an unbelievable turnaround and something the Bobcats should be so proud of, because going into the year, I don't think anyone had Quinnipiac on their charts of making the Frozen Four, let alone winning the Cleary Cup. Now, what's even more impressive to me is that they had 10 freshmen on the ice tonight. That's unbelievable when you're facing the reigning national champions, Minnesota Duluth, that it was a 1-goal game with only a few minutes left. They had freshmen step up. Ethan DeYoung and Wyatt Bongiovanni on the first line right there with Odin Tufto, who's only a sophomore. That's one of the best first lines in ECAC hockey. Then they also have Peter DeLiberatore, who's a Golden Knights draft pick. He played unbelievable all year round, adding depth to that defensive core. Then you also have guys like William Fallstrom, who was fantastic at center all year long, possessing the puck for Quinnipiac. There's a bright future for the Bobcats as long as this strong group of young players sticks together. Because as Rand Pecknold said, when you have successful years, sometimes those players are going to go and turn pro. So if the Bobcats lose someone like Andrew Shortridge, who is the best goalie in the NCAA all year long, they might be in trouble next year. But if they stay together, you know, they're losing a couple key players like Chase Prisky and the rest of the seniors that we'll get to in just a minute. This could be a good future for Quinnipiac.
Certainly a very solid group of underclassmen. As you said, 9-10 freshmen on any given day. And for them to get NCAA experience in their first year, very important. But you make a good point. Shortridge could leave. Brogan Rafferty's a junior. He could leave. Carlos Schuksta, also a draft pick. He could be out. So it's really, you know, the next couple weeks and months maybe telling on what this team's roster is going to look like next year. But Kyle, you've mentioned it. We've talked about it a couple times now. This senior class has been instrumental. They've made it to a Frozen Four, even a national championship game their freshman year. 2 years after that, they did not see much success. No national tournament appearances. And now here they are. They're in the Midwest Regional. They were the 2 seed. They fall short and don't make it to Buffalo, but nonetheless, a source of pride for these guys. Let's have a listen.
That was something going into playoffs that we wanted to, you know, leave somewhat of a legacy. Obviously, last year was the first losing record season in Quinnipiac history, or 20 years of Quinnipiac. And I guess it's nice knowing that we accomplished what we did this year and then ending on that.
Yeah, I think, you know, definitely we turned the program around this year with, you know, how well we did with the 26 wins and, you know, making it this far in the tournament. I think, you know, last year when the season ended, the returners took it to themselves to, you know, turn this program around and restore the culture. And, you know, it obviously sucks right now to, you know, fall just, you know, 2 goals short of a Frozen Four. But, you know, it was a really good season, and, you know, hopefully we can build on into next year.
tough toe there, an underclassman, Kyle, with high praise for his captain and that senior class. So, I mean, what can you say about these guys?
I want to start with some of the guys that don't get as much attention as others. So let's start with Brandon Fortunato, who missed the end of the season. One of the top six defensive players in the country, according to his head coach, Rand Pecknold. That loss completely changed everything for the Bobcats. According to Rand, when he was on the ice, they only had one loss all season, and then they were just hovering around 500 the rest of the year when he wasn't around. The power play severely struggled. Rand even said that he was the best player Quinnipiac had the second half of the season. So losing him might have been the difference for them going to Buffalo and not going to Buffalo. So for him transferring from Boston University to Quinnipiac, that's a huge move. Let's move on to Luke Shiplow. It was very important as a freshman in their run to the Frozen Four. Has been a key player moving from forward to defense, really doing whatever Pecknold asks of him on any given day. He's been fantastic his whole career. One of the smaller players on the team, but it has a heart of gold. And then you also have Scott Davidson, an assistant captain. He's been a fantastic player all year long. He might not, or all career long, it might not always show up on the score sheet, but he's always doing the things that Pecknold preaches. That's blocking shots, that's winning battles, winning races. I remember sophomore year, he didn't have a goal all year long, but the things he does as a leader can't be overstated. Pecknold was even getting emotional at the end of his press conference, talking about just how good of a heart Davidson has and how great of a future Davidson has. He's been great. Craig Martin, we saw him tonight with Quinnipiac's lone goal. You know, he is a very skilled player. He's been great. Came up huge for Quinnipiac tonight, almost got them the lead. And then finally, Chase Prisky. Everyone's been talking about him all year long. One of the best players I've ever seen come through Quinnipiac. If there's a Mount Rushmore for Quinnipiac men's ice hockey players, Prisky is on the list. A two-time captain. Pecknold has called him one of the best captains. The most points ever scored by a Quinnipiac defenseman, and a future NHL career is certainly on the horizon for Prisky. I can't say enough good things about him. He's a Hobey Baker candidate this year. I think he should win it based off the intangibles that he brings and just how different he makes Quinnipiac. It's a fantastic senior class, hovering around 100 wins for their career. They're definitely going to be missed, MJ, but the impact they've made on this program, changing it from where it was last year and even 2 years ago and bringing it back up to the perennial powerhouse that it is unbelievable.
Setting the tone for Quinnipiac hockey to come, years to come. So this is the end for this senior class, and this is the end for the Quinnipiac season. It's also the end for you and I, Kyle. We've covered this team for 4 years now. Ups, downs, all in between. We've been there. We've had a lot of fun. So as these players take off their jerseys for the last time, we guess I take off our press passes one last time.
Yeah, I guess that's the best way to put it.
I guess that's what we'll have to call it. All right. So long from Allentown, Pennsylvania, the Midwest Regional, Minnesota Duluth, moving on to the Frozen Four. Quinnipiac sees its season come to an end. Thanks so much for tuning in, not only today, but all season long. Check out all of our content, Q30TV.com, as well as Q30 Sports on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all the social media, you name it. One more time from, what is it, PPL Arena?
PPL Center in Allentown, Pennsylvania, with my friend, MJ Baird. Can I take it this time?
Go right ahead.
We'll see you next time.